broken.
Clunk, clunk.
What are you videoing?
Yeah, the springs would do that. Well, I'm videoing pulling some ECMs.
Why?
For people that want to learn how to pull ECMs out. See, people are like, hey, Andrew, I got some ECMs, but they don't even know where they're located. They're like, oh, I got some Ford trucks. I got some Ford vans, but they have no idea where it's going. It all depends on what year, right? Holy, that sounds bad. Does this thing have brakes on it?
None. No calipers, no nothing. I took the calipers and everything off so it doesn't freeze up.
So it wouldn't interfere.
Yeah, hopefully nobody jumps out in front of us.
So what are you pulling today?
I'm pulling a glass out of Montana van. One of those right there. I need a quarter glass out of it.
Quarter glass? Those are big bucks if they don't have the if they don't have like the sliding door. You ever seen one of those? Oh, anyways, there's not many of them around.
And they're worth money, the vans without the sliding door.
That's right.
Really?
Yeah, on like the driver's side, because they all have, they're all pretty much standard now, so.
Well, this is about as far as I'm going.
Well, that's good enough. I brought the wrong footwear for today, but oh well. Gonna get a little wet. Not a problem though.
Well, I'd give you a ride around with the guys up front waiting for this window. So
yeah. Alright, these old vans usually have a big motor in them. So the first thing I do is I try to open up the door, and of course it's busted. But anyways, you take a 8mm, and underneath there's just a little... I take an extension and an 8mm, and I just stick it right about there in the middle, and then undo that. Then I come around to the firewall, and then undo that side. Then I come back and I just pull it out. So I iron did this one already, now it's the time to get underneath the hood. And then you just rip all that crap out of the way, and then you can slide your hand down in there and turn it with the 10mm. Listen to that sad, sorry thing. She's in really rough shape. So I just pulled it out, and then you see that E9TF, and then that ASA. That middle part just means it's a gasoline engine. And I checked it out, and this is just a 5 liter, and I'm gonna just run the numbers on my list and see what it's worth. Now I buy these anywhere from $10 to $50 a piece. Here's another Jaguar. It's good to know in case I need some little part or whatever. Slightly different than my style, but yeah, you can see everything that's been kind of gone over here. Even look at the contacts, eh? Similar to the Mercedes one, and it has that fake wood grain stuff. They always have a tendency to do that. Very similar to the Mercedes that I got. Huh. Don't see too many of these anymore, at least around here. Oh yeah, of course it has the Jaguar emblem taken off of it. All kinds of derby cars, some newer Chevys, a little bit of everything. Now these older Dakotas, they have them in the passenger side fender under the hood, and the numbers are always printed on right here. So I go by those. It's just 3 8mm, take it off. Now if it has a authorized software update, then you have to go by that number on the list, because this has been changed to that number. Okay, for the newer style Ford van, you simply, under the hood, do some prying, and you can read the numbers just off of there. So I just take this in there, and I just pry it, and then I can read the numbers, and then I check on my list and see if it's worth anything. Then you just take, it's a whole nother process to take these out. What I do is I take the 10mm on this side, undo that, then I go on the inside and I actually break the air vent and I pull it out through the inside. I find that these bolts that are on the firewall, those bolts down in, down there, and then on the other side, you can't even, most of the times they'll just end up spinning. So ideally they would come out the front engine compartment, but those end up spinning, so I don't even attempt them. And then there's one of those goodies over there too, so we'll grab that one. Now these new style Fords, I don't really bother with much because there's not much demand for them, and they're kind of a pain to get out. And I even forget where they were. I think they were inside somewhere in the glove compartment. I forget, but I think they're just down there. Yeah, so they're a bit of a pain to get at. So there's not much demand yet for them. But look at this diesel. I was just looking at this, and look at that turbo. You know, it's getting some water into that, and they should stick something in there, like a rag or something, unless the turbo is what caused the engine to go on this Chevy Duramax. But it just seems like quite a waste. And then here again, here's an older style Dakota, and it's right here on that panel. And I checked the numbers and they're one off, so fortunately it's not worth anything, so I just leave it in the vehicle. Now the new style Dodge full-size pickup, the CCM is located on here. Looks like somebody got frustrated trying to pull it. All the tabs are there and everything, but look at, they tried to pry that and then they started beating on it with a hammer. What a waste. I don't know why they would wreck a perfectly good one like that, but oh well. And then look at this nice big Ford. These ones I haven't seen. I haven't seen too many of these yet in the auto wreckers. Oh, it's already gone. You can see when you see the light through there, you know it's already gone. Unfortunately, this is a big old gasser. All right, for this 88 Ford, you can tell it's 88 because it says it right in the windshield. Anyways, you take that 10 mil there, and then you peel back that kick panel, and then you take the 8 mil that holds it into place and just take it out, and it comes out through the inside. This is an old styled F-150. He's having some fun over there with that loader. One car pile even toppled over there. Now for these old Dodge pickups, you just open up the hood and it's right down in there. Now even the older ones that are still carbureted still have a spark controller, and then some of them are even mounted to the air breather, the air cleaner. So they'll have like a part number on the air cleaner box. So even those are worth some money. They're not worth that much. I mean, nobody drives them, but I'm just saying that some of the ones that are overlooked are actually some goodies. This is what happened to their old loader. Oh wow, that hydraulic ram would be big bucks. And they must have got rid of that engine to a wholesaler or something like that, because I imagine they probably blew it up. But yeah, this takes a while to go through all the vehicles. Last time I was here was about, I guess, 3-4 months ago. So there's always something new to go through. Anyways, this new style Ford pickup, this is what I was talking about, is you can sneak in through here. You can take a look, you just peel back that down there, peel that fender, and then you can get the shot at to look at that ECM, and you can read it. That's a F3TF ZB. So that's how you read those without even taking them out. Of course, the tire being off helps out greatly. And then I just take the 10 mil and then I just bust those two nuts off there, and then I just pry it out and pull it out with that fender pulled down, like that fender inside plastic part. I just push that down and pull the ECM out, and that's how you do it, folks.